I don't fucking I but the thing that gets me about cops is that they just fucking do what they're told. They just it's like crush the Occupy movement. All right, well, crush the Occupy
movement. In history have the police been at the forefront of a positive social change. Yeah. At best, they're being dragged along by history.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. They break up strikes.
Yeah.
They're always on the side of the rich. They're always on the fucking side of the rich.
Because that's what the scam is. And, you know, having police isn't normal. There's times in history where there was no such thing as police, where everything was just done communally and community-based.
Right, but that was one of the things I wanted to kind of touch on, that you touched on when you said that TV is your friend. It fucking struck a chord that there. Where is the community? Where are the communities, like real community?
You know, Alan Watts has talked about that.
Has he? What did he say?
I love it. It's one of my favorite clips he has where he's like...
Alan Watts, by the way, people who don't know, he was the creator of Candid Camera. Go ahead. Oh, no, that's Alan Funt.
Wait,
hold on.
Wait, I'll do Alan Watts' Candid Camera. Smile.
That's great.
For you are on Candid Camera.
No, but what did Watts say about
he
community?
Goes, he says, you know, when you take a walk around any American city, mm-hmm. And this is back in the 70s, he's saying this, mm-hmm. you take a walk around any American city at evening time, after dinner, before dinner, walk around, and what you will see is not the sight that you would have seen through most of history of people laughing on their front porches and talking with each other. You'll see the steady blue...
Was he a Brit?
Yeah. You'll see the steady blue flicker from inside their living rooms.
And what year was this?
Probably... He died in 73, so it's probably...
Oh, my God. Because it's gotten far worse.
It's far worse.
From 73.
Yeah. But he described back then how unthinkable it would be to see people hanging out. And it's not, that's not 100%. Depending on the neighborhood, people know their neighbors or whatever. But like,
yeah, but they kind of,
but mostly people watch TV a lot.
You see, mile after mile of darkened houses with that little electronic screen flickering in the room. Everybody isolated, watching this thing. And thus, in no real communion with each other at all. And this isolation of people into a private world of their own is really the creation of a mindless crowd. And so, we don't get with each other, except for public expressions of getting rid of our hostility, like football or prize fighting. And even in the spectacles one sees on this television, it's perfectly proper to exhibit people slugging and slaying each other, but oh dear no, not people loving each other, except in a rather restrained way. One can only draw the conclusion that the assumption underlying this is that expressions of physical love are far more dangerous than expressions of physical hatred. And it seems to me that a culture that has that sort of assumption is basically crazy and devoted. Unintentionally, indeed, but nevertheless, in fact, devoted. Not to survival, but to the actual destruction of life.